Assalamualaikum everyone. Today we are going to learn a topic, a very interesting topic under law of thought. For today we will focus on the negligence only. Alright. Okay, first of all I need to know what is your understanding in regards to law of thought. I believe that you have heard this term before. Okay, thought basically means a civil wrong, which relates to a wrong committed against an individual. In other words, okay, plaintiff and defendant would be individual against individual, and this is a branch of private law. Thoughts are different from crimes, in the sense that a crime is a wrong committed against the public goods, right? So you have to differentiate between a thought and crimes, because if you take action under thought, you will claim the monetary compensation, okay, or damages. But if you take action under a crime, for example using a penal code, you will ask the court to provide sanction or punishment to the wrongdoer. And the main purpose of tort is to provide the individual who has suffered from an infringement of right and duty with a remedy to enforce their right. For example, if a person is suffering from a negligence resulted from the act of the third party, so the innocent party here can claim for damages or compensation. So thought of law, sorry, so law of thought is aimed to compensate the victim for injuries caused by the tortfeasor. Tortfeasor here is the wrongdoer who committed tort. The person injured is normally called as the victim or innocent party, plaintiff or claimant, while the tortfeasor is the defendant in lawsuit. He is a wrongdoer. Okay, basically there are different types of tort. Okay, we have a thought of negligence, thought of defamation. Okay, for defamation we are going to learn on next week, and then a trespass to person that may be divided into three: assault, a battery, and a forced imprisonment. And last but not least, in your syllabus, we will cover thought of nuisance. Okay. So for today's lessons, we are going to focus on law of negligence. Okay. Learning objective for today, at the end of the lessons, you should be able to first to understand what is meant by thought of negligence. You need to define negligence. Okay, therefore when you are answering the problematic question later, you must start your answer with definitions of negligence. Second, to identify all the elements of negligence. Okay, we have three elements of negligence, and in order for the claimant to take action against the defendant, okay, he must prove these three elements, and then to apply the legal principles to the given facts and demonstrate critically when answering problematic questions. This is the main part of law of thought. You need to advise the parties, the concerned parties. This is how you apply the law into the given situation. Okay, next, what is negligence? Okay, according to the definition given by the dictionary, negligence means lack of proper care and attentions. Literally, it means that the breach of a legal duty to take care which results in damage to the plaintiff undesired by the defendant. Who will suffer damage? The plaintiff. Okay, who breached the legal duty? The defendant. Defendant is the tortfeasor. Defendant is the wrongdoer here. Okay, and then plaintiff is the claimant or a victim. There are three elements of negligence that must be fulfilled. First, there must be a duty of care owed by the defendant to the plaintiff. Second, the breach of duty of care by the defendant, and the consequential damage to the plaintiff. These three elements are very important. Okay. Plaintiff must suffer damage. Right. First elements and the duty of care. What is duty of care? Okay, basically the defendant must owe a duty of care to the plaintiff. Okay, it is an obligation recognized by law to avoid conduct fraught with unreasonable risk of danger to others. Meaning to say that you must try to protect the other party. Okay, you owe the duty of care. Duty in the term of negligence means a legal duty imposed by the law, not moral or social duty. This is means of legal duty under tort of negligence. And the duty must arise out of some relation or some proximity between the parties based on the close relationships. For example, between a driver and road user, between a manufacturer and consumer, between a builder and buyer, between a teacher and students, for example. Okay, in order to determine whether there is an existence of a duty of care or not, we need to apply this principle. This principle is known as neighbor principle. And this principle was laid down in the landmark case of Donahue against Stevenson. Okay, when you learn law of negligence, this is the first case that you must understand. Bila you faham this case, the landmark case, meaning that you are going to remember what are the elements of negligence. And the most important thing is the first element, okay, duty of care. So what happened in this case? Okay, you may refer to the facts here. The defendant in this case is a ginger beer manufacturer. So he was a manufacturer. Sold ginger beer to a retailer and the ginger beer bottles were opaque. A bought a bottle and entertained her friends at the plaintiff who drank the ginger beer. When A refilled the glass, along with the ginger beer, came out the decomposed remains of a snail. The plaintiff suffered shock and was severely ill as a consequence. The plaintiff sued the manufacturer and claimed that the manufacturer had a duty in the course of his business to prevent snails from entering his ginger beer bottles, and further that the defendant had a duty to ensure that all empty bottles were carefully inspected before they were filled with ginger beer. In this situation, basically after drank the ginger beer, the plaintiff suffered diarrhea. Okay, shock. So he was shocked. And this is the damage suffered by the plaintiff. So the issue need to be determined in this case is whether the defendant, the manufacturer, owed such duty to the plaintiff. Duty here referred to duty of care. Whether the manufacturer owed a duty of care to the plaintiff here, Mr. Donahue. And the court held that the test to determine the existence or otherwise of such a duty was whether the plaintiff was the neighbor of the defendant. So this is the thing that you must determine, whether the plaintiff here was the neighbor to the defendant, to the manufacturer. So based on this case, okay, the House of Lords held that the manufacturer owed a duty of care to the plaintiff, which was breached, and because it was reasonably foreseeable that failure to ensure the safety of the product would lead to harm the consumer. So this was the court held of this case. Okay, and Mr. Donahue win the case. Okay, so if you go through the full facts of the case, you will notice that the three elements of negligence have been fulfilled in this case. Okay, and the neighbor principle was formulated by Lord Atkin as follow. Okay, the rule that you are to love your neighbor becomes in law. You must not injure your neighbor, and the lawyer's question, who is my neighbor? And receive a restricted reply. Okay, you must take reasonable care to avoid acts or omissions which you can reasonably foreseeable would be likely to injure your neighbor. Neighbor here bukan bermaksud jiran kita. Okay, this is the one who. Okay, next the question. Who then in law is my neighbor? The answer seems to be persons who are so closely and directly affected by my act that I ought reasonably to have them in my contemplation as being so affected when I am directing my mind to the acts or omission which are called in question. So, we can conclude that neighbor is a person that is closely related to us. Okay, apa yang kita buat will directly affect our neighbor. Okay, so applying this principle, okay, the court held that the manufacturer in this case was liable. Okay, what are the important edges, okay, established from this case? First, it created a new category of duty owed by the manufacturer to the consumer. Even bukan consumer tu yang beli. Okay, his friends, right? Like what happened in this case. But consumer who drank the ginger beer. And then second, the court had taken into account new technology. In example, mass production in the impositions of liability for negligence. So this is called as objective test. The court will ask the hypothetical question, would a reasonable man who is in the same circumstances as the defendant foresee that his conduct will adversely affect the plaintiff? If the answer is no, the plaintiff is not a neighbor. But if the answer is yes, then the plaintiff is a neighbor, person that is closely related to you. Okay? So close means foresight of a reasonable man who is able to foresee that the plaintiff will be affected by the defendant's act or omissions. Okay, so the first element is you must satisfy that there was a duty of care owed by the defendant towards the plaintiff. Okay, later we continue with the second element.